أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، خصوصا على أفضلهم وخاتم النبيين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يسألونك عن الأهلة قل هي مواقيت للناس والحج وليس البر بأن تأتوا البيوت من ظهورها ولكن البر من اتقى وأتوا البيوت من أبوابها واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون. وقاتلوا في سبيل الله الذين يقاتلونكم ولا تعتدوا إن الله لا يحب المعتدين. واقتلوهم حيث ثقفتموهم وأخرجوهم من حيث أخرجوكم والفتنة أشد من القتل. ولا تقاتلوهم عند المسجد الحرام حتى يقاتلوكم فيه، فإن قاتلوكم فاقتلوهم كذلك جزاء الكافرين. فإن انتهوا فإن الله غفور رحيم. وقاتلوهم حتى لا تكون فتنة ويكون الدين لله، فإن انتهوا فلا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، فتقبل منا فإنك خير المتقبلين. آمين يا رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Tonight we are proceeding with the 24th section of Surah Al-Baqarah. As I have told you more than one times, this Surah Al-Baqarah, which is the biggest and the greatest surah of the Quran, is divisible into two parts. First part comprising of 18 sections or 152 ayat, in which the main address was to the Bani Israel, to the former Muslim Ummah. The second part that started from the 19th section, and this will go on till the end of the surah. In this part, only a very brief reference was in the 19th section to the Jews, and then in the 20th section there was some reference to the pagan Arabs, to the idolaters of Arabia. Rest of the whole surah is addressed now towards the Muslims, the Muslim Ummah. And there are four threads of subjects or topics which are interwoven, wound round each other. That is why we feel they are broken, but they are not broken. Actually, the threads are continuous. The four threads are two concerning the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And here we'll find that the blueprint of the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the divine law of Islam, that is prepared in this part of the surah. But the Sharia contains two parts. Firstly, ibadat, modes of worship. We'll find a brief reference to prayers, salah. Then the detailed discussion about psalm we have studied last night. Today we are going to study a very detailed discussion about hajj, and its rites and rituals. The second is Mu'amalat, the social affairs of the community. A few references have already come regarding the law of equitable retribution in cases of murder, regarding, you know, inheritance, the preliminary instruction about inheritance, and so on. But now you will see in the sections that we will be studying today, repeatedly, the ayat will start, Yas'alunak, Yas'alunak, Yas'alunak. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are asking you, they are asking you. They are asking you about the orphans. They are asking you about wine. They are asking you about gambling. They are asking you about the menstruation, the period of women, etc., etc. Because, you know, now it was a society of the Muslims, their own society. And now, you know, all the rules and regulations are being given. And there was an urge in the people themselves to know what we should do. So question after question, and we shall be getting the answers. The other two strands or threads of the topics, they are the two aspects of jihad fi sabilillah. And here we find that the jihad now has converted into qital. For 12 long years at Makkah it was jihad. It was not an armed conflict. It was jihad bil Qur'an, وَجَاهِدْهُمْ بِهِ جِهَادًا كَبِيرًا. But now you know this jihad has turned into qital, going to war for the cause of Allah, fighting the kuffar who were obstructing the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So qital fi sabilillah, and for qital you always need funds, money, because for the armor also and all the other needs for going to war, you need, you know, money. So infaq fi sabilillah. These two strands, qital fi sabilillah, infaq fi sabilillah. And these four strands are wound round each other or interwoven, and we shall find that once one subject is discussed, then the second one, then the third one, then the fourth one, and so on. So they seem to be interrupted, but actually they are continuous. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَحِلَّةِ. Here, the same question. They are asking you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the new moons. قُلْ هِيَ مَوَاقِيتُ لِلنَّاسِ. Tell them, they are for reckoning the periods of times for the people. This is the calendar, the natural calendar that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to whole of humanity. Citing the moon, you can see whether half of the month has passed or the third of the month has passed. So it is actually the natural calendar that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided. Yes, قُلْ هِيَ مَوَاقِيتُ لِلنَّاسِ وَالْحَجِّ. And especially because Hajj was the most important phenomenon in Arabia. And it was performed in definite months, on definite dates. So this importance of the calendar was mostly for Hajj. وَلَيْسَ الْبِرُّ بِأَنْ تَعْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهَا. And this is no charity, this is no virtue, that you enter your houses from the backs. It was a wrong practice of the Arabs of Makkah, that once they took to Ihram for Hajj, and they came out of their houses. Now if there was some need to go back, they thought that we can't now enter our homes from the front doors. So they used to climb the hind walls and then jump into the houses. Because we are now in Ihram, we can't enter our houses. So this was actually their own self-made ideas. So Quran is telling us it has no basis. وَلَيْسَ الْبِرُّ بِأَنْ تَعْتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهَا. It's no virtue that you come to your houses from their backs. وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنِ التَّقْوَى. The real virtue, the real charity of the person who has real taqwa, who is really pious, who is really God-fearing, who really wants to save him from all evil. وَاتُوا الْبُيُوتَ مِنْ أَبْوَابِهَا. No harm if you have taken to Ihram, but if there is need to return to your homes, you can enter your homes through the front doors. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. But have taqwa of Allah, have regard of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that you can prosper. And now with the just mention in one ayah of Hajj, we find the discussion of qital fi sabilillah. What's the logical relationship? Hajj could be performed only at Makkah, And Makkah was under the control of the non-believers, the mushrikeen, the kuffar. So it had to be liberated. And for getting Makkah liberated from the clutches of the kuffar, Muslims had to go to war. There's no other way, no alternative, no possible method. That is why just mentioning Hajj, and then, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala switches towards qital fi sabilillah, and then, you know, detailed discussion about Hajj will follow. وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ. And go to war. Fight those in the cause of Allah who are fighting you. وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا. But don't transgress the limits. The limits of decency, the limits of morality, that must be kept. There are laws in Islam. You are not free to do whatever you like to do against your enemy. You can't kill the old people, the sick people, the women. You can't burn trees. You can't burn the fields, the harvest, no. So you have to observe the rules and regulations based on moral law. وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ. This is the first ayah mentioning and so prescribing qital fi سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ to the Muslims. وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا. But don't transgress the limits. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. Verily Allah doesn't like those who transgress the limits. وَقْتِلُوهُمْ حَيْثُ ثَقِفْتُمُوهُمْ. Kill them wherever you find them. These are very strong words. Because actually, they had done all, you know, persecution to the Muslims for at least 8 years. They had turned them out from Makkah. The Muslims had to leave Makkah. They had to leave their homes and hearts. They had to leave their families at the mercy of the wolves of Makkah. So actually, now the Muslims had every moral right to retaliate. Up till that time, they were stopped by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to retaliate. That's a different issue. It's the wisdom of the revolutionary process of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But now that phase has started, so don't hesitate in killing. This is necessary. Just as a surgeon, you know, he cuts off the arm or the leg of a person because it has become venomous. If you don't chop it off, if you don't cut it off, maybe the whole body goes, you know. So here actually, وَاقْتُلُوهُمْ حَيْثُ ثَقِفْتُمُوهُمْ. Kill them wherever you find them. وَأَخْرِجُوهُمْ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَخْرَجُوكُمْ. And turn them out from where they have turned you out. They have turned you out from Mecca, you turn them out from Mecca. وَالْفِتْنَةُ أَشَدُّ مِنَ الْقَتْلِ. And fitna is worse than qatl. Why it is being said? Because there are some people, and there were some people, and there will always be some people, good-natured or weak in personality, who would say it's no good going to war, it's, you know, shedding blood is no good. We should refrain as much as we can. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, no. Well, fitna to ashadda min al-qatl. Fitna is worse than qatl, worse than killing or murdering. What is fitna? Fitna primarily means persecution. Because the kuffar had been persecuting the Muslims, they had been beating them. So actually now, they deserve it. Number two, every condition in which a mu'min, if he is placed in that environment, he feels difficulty to practice Islam, it is fitna. The whole system, political, socio-economic system, which is not based on Islam, which is not under the sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is fitna, it is fasad, it is rebellion against him. So وَالْفِتْنَةُ أَشَدُّ مِنَ الْقَتْلِ. وَلَا تُقَاتِلُهُمْ مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. But don't go to fight against them near the sacred mosque. You have to keep the sanctity of Baytullah. حَتَّى يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ فِيهِ. Till that time that they go to war against you near that mosque. If they themselves injure the sanctity, now then you are also free to retaliate. فَإِنْ قَاتَلُوكُمْ. If they fight against you near the sacred mosque, فَقْتُلُوهُمْ. Then kill them there also. كَذَلِكَ جَزَاءُ الْكَافِرِينَ. Such is the reward for these kuffar, for these unbelievers, for these who are opposing the deen of Allah and the messenger of Allah and his mission. فَإِنْ اِنْتَهُوا, then if they desist, if they leave, if they change their attitude, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, that is, they also submit, submit before Allah, submit before His Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, so Allah is forgiving and merciful. وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةٌ, now when this phase of your struggle has started, continue this war. This war will be continuous. قَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةٌ, till such time that all persecution ends, all fitna is finished. And what is the second meaning of fitna which I told you, that is clear from this ayah? وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ لِلَّهِ, what is the ending of this fitna? That the deen should become for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The whole system of life should come under the deen of Allah, under the supremacy of the divine law. That is the fitna. Unless the whole social system is under the supremacy of divine law, it is under the sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the real sovereign of this universe, till such time, although there might be peace, apparent peace, it's fitna, it is fasad, it is rebellion against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the duty of the faithful who believe in Allah and really believe in Allah, who really believe in Sharia, that to establish the deen of Allah and to impose the rules and regulations of the deen of Allah, they have to go to war and they have to continue their battle, their war, till that fitna is finished, until the whole system, political, socio-economic system, comes under divine law. وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةٌ وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ لِلَّهِ فَإِنْ انْتَهَوْا فَلَا عُدْوَانَ إِلَّا عَلَى الظَّالِمِينَ, and then if they desist, if they give up this opposition to the deen of Allah, then there should be no aggression against, فَلَا عُدْوَانَ إِلَّا عَلَى الظَّالِمِينَ, except against the unjust, against the evildoers, against the criminals. But when they give up and they surrender, then there should be no transgression against them. الشهر الحرام بالشهر الحرام, the sacred month is for the sacred month. If they have injured the sanctity of the sacred month, just as the sacred mosque, now the sacred month, الشهر الحرام, if they go to war against you in the sacred months, then you can also go to war against them. If they have violated the sanctity of the sacred months, well, nothing will stop you. You have to retaliate. الشهر الحرام بالشهر الحرام والحرمات قصاص, there should be equitable retaliation in all such sacred matters. فَمَنْ اِعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَاعْتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ بِمِثْلِ مَا اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ, if somebody is committing aggression against you, you also be aggressive against them, just in the manner in which they were aggressive upon you. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ, but in during all this process, never forget Allah. Always have Him in your mind and heart. Have His taqwa within your hearts. Regard Him. Think. You must always think that He is seeing you. And you are responsible. You don't break any divine law. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ, and you must know and keep it in mind always that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only with the muttaqeen. That is His help. That will be only if you have taqwa. If you don't have taqwa, you can't hope for His help. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ, even during war, as I told you, you are not free to do whatever you like. No. The moral law has to be kept in mind. All the divine injunctions regarding war and battle, they have also been kept to be mind. Now the second strand of jihad fi sabilillah, here it is mentioned in only one ayah, and then you will find, you know, gradually. And in the end of this surah, there are two sections, which are devoted to this. وَأَنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّهْلُكَةِ, for these battles, for this going to war, you need money, you need funds, you need arms. And arms need money. So along with your own lives and your bodies, you have to contribute your money, your wealth. وَأَنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, and expend in the cause of Allah, for the way of Allah. وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّهْلُكَةِ And don't throw yourself with your own hands in disaster and ruination. If you are behaving miserly with the deen of Allah, what is it? You are actually throwing yourself in the fire of hell. So don't throw yourself to the ruination and disaster of the fire of hell. If you don't pay, if you don't contribute, if you don't spend for the cause of Allah, actually you are throwing yourself as if in the hell, in the fire of hell. وَأَحْسِنُوا And do good. Your Islam should be a beautiful Islam. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who do good deeds. Now again, this was an interpolation. The subject of Hajj had started, but you know, in between these injunctions regarding going to war, very important. And now all the instructions about the manasik, about the rites and rituals of Hajj, they are coming. وَأَتِمُّ الْحَجَّ وَالْعُمْرَةَ لِلَّهِ And complete all the rites and rituals of Hajj and Umrah for Allah. Because one goes for Hajj and one goes for Umrah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of his pleasure. وَأَتِمُّ إِتْمَام To complete. Once you have taken to Ihram, once you have made the intention, now you have to complete all the rituals. فَإِنْ أُحْصِرْتُمْ If you are obstructed, if you are prevented, somebody in the way stops you, you can't go to Makkah Mukarramah, then offer to Allah فَمَا اسْتَيْسَرَ مِنَ الْحَجِّ Then whatever sacrifice you can offer, you offer there and then, which you had to offer at Makkah. But because you have been obstructed in the way, here you know, you can offer the sacrifice. وَلَا تَحْنِقُوا رُؤُسَكُمْ حَتَّى يَبْلُغَ الْحَدْيُ مَحِلَّةِ And don't shave your heads unless that sacrifice has reached its place. You have to send that sacrifice towards Makkah and wait till such time that you think that the sacrifice now could have reached Makkah, that's the place of that sacrifice. Now you can shave your heads, that is, now you can finish your ihram. فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيدًا أَوْ بِهِ أَذًى مِنْ رَأْسِهِ And then whosoever amongst you is ill or sick, and there is some ailment in his head that needs shaving, فَفِدْيَةٌ مِنْ سِيَامٍ So you have to do the redemption. That redemption can be done through keeping fast, fasting or sadaqatin, giving alms, or nusuk, or another sacrifice. That is called dame jinaya, because you are contravening the law. Here you have to present a sacrifice additional. فَإِذَا أَمِنْتُمْ And if you are in peace, now you have reached Makkah. فَمَنْ تَمَتَّعَ بِالْعُمْرَةِ إِلَى الْحَجِّ So whosoever avails with performing Umrah before Hajj, فَمَا اسْتَيْسَرَ مِنَ الْحَجِّ He should also again present an additional qurbani, an additional sacrifice for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is according to Imam Abu Hanifa, this is Dame Shukr. Because before Islam, in one journey, only either Hajj could be performed or Umrah, not both. But in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easier for the Muslim Ummah. If you are performing one journey, but you can do, first you go and do Umrah, then you open your ihram, or you can continue it also, that is Hajj al-Qiran. And if you have opened your ihram, finished your ihram, now you are staying at Makkah as a normal citizen, then it is called Hajj al-Tamattu. So this additional ease that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for you, that in one journey you can perform Umrah as well as Hajj, for that you have to present a sacrifice. فَمَا اسْتَيْسَرَ مِنَ الْحَجِّ فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ فَصِيَامُ ثَلَاثَةِ أَيَّامٍ But there can be someone who cannot afford to pay for the sacrifice, can't purchase the goat or the sheep or so on. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجِدْ Who doesn't find? فَصِيَامُ ثَلَاثَةِ أَيَّامٍ فِي الْحَجِّ Here again there is fitna, there is fidya, that is redemption. And that redemption is 3 days fasting during the Hajj. وَسَبْعَةٍ إِذَا رَجَعْتُمْ. And 7 more when you go back to your houses, your homes. تِلْكَ عَشَرَةٌ كَامِلَةٌ. 10 days fasting would take the place of that hadi, of that sacrifice. عَشَرَةٌ كَامِلَةٌ. ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ أَهْلُهُ حَاضِرِ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. And this is only for those people whose families are not settled near the sacred mosque, whom we call afaqi, who go from outside world to perform Hajj. But there, you know, people who are living at Makkah, they need not give this sacrifice, additional sacrifice. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Have regard for Allah. Have fear of Allah. وَعْلَمُوا. And keep it in mind. أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. That Allah is very severe in punishment. Don't contravene these laws. These laws are to be obeyed. الْحَجُّ أَشْهُرٌ مَعْلُومَاتٌ. The months in which Hajj can be performed are very well known. فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجِّ. So whosoever has made a firm intention that he is to perform Hajj, he should know. فَلَا رَفَسَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ. That during this period, when one is in Ihram, there can be no sexual indulgence, there should be no obscenity in speech, there should be no jidal, there should be no fighting, quarreling or arguing with each other. وَمَا تَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمْهُ اللَّهُ. Instead of these things, you have to do good. And whatever good you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will know it. It will not go in vain. It will be in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He will reward you. وَتَزَوَّدُوا. And have the provision with you. فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادِ التَّقْوَى. And the best provision is taqwa. You have all the money with you to spend there, but there's no taqwa. To what avail? You get nothing out of it then. So you must have taqwa. The first thing, the foremost thing is taqwa. But in addition to taqwa, you must have the money to spend where you shouldn't go and beg there. Because if you don't have the money, then Hajj is not farz, not obligatory upon you. You should have your own, you know, expenditure with you. Don't go and beg there. فَتَزَوَّدُوا. You must have the provisions with you. فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادِ التَّقْوَى. And of all the provisions, the best is taqwa. That is the must. That should be the foremost. وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. O people of understanding, have my taqwa. That is the last warning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَن تَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. There will be no sin upon you if you want to get the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But does it mean if you are going for Hajj and you take some merchandise with you, you sell it there, you earn some money, some profit, it's not haram, it's not forbidden, you can do it. لَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَن تَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِّن رَبِّكُمْ فَإِذَا أَفَضْتُم مِّنْ عَرَفَاتٍ. And when you return from Arafat, فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ عِندَ الْمَشْعَرِ الْحَرَامِ. Then you know, make zikr of Allah. Remember Allah in the Mashar al-Haram, that is Muzdalifah. I can't go into detail. When we return on the 9th, you know, of Dhul Hijj, that is the Yawmul Arafah. Then in the evening they return. And the night is passed as Muzdalifah. And we reached then Mina back at the morning of the 10th. So that is Muzdalifah, Mashar al-Haram. وَذْكُرُوهُ كَمَا هَدَاكُمْ. And you must remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He has taught you. Not on your own. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught you how to offer prayers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His messenger has taught you the method of zikr. وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَمَا هَدَاكُمْ. Don't invent yourself new methods of zikr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already given you the guidance how to remember Him. وَإِن كُنْتُم مِّن قَبْلِهِ لَمِنَ الضَّالِّينَ. Verily, before this time you were from those people who have gone astray. You had just forgotten the real spirit of Hajj before Islam. The Hajj was continuing, but the spirit of Hajj was no more there. ثُمَّ أَفِيضُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ أَفَاضَ النَّاسِ. Then you should return from where the other people return. Because, you know, the Quraysh, they had made it that only the other people should go to Arafat. They kept staying at Mina. All the 5 days of Hajj, they were at Mina. They didn't go to Arafat. It's very hard going to, coming back from Arafat. One day journey, you know, it's very hard. They said it is for other people who come from outside. We are the custodians of Kaaba. We need not go outside Haram. So they remain at Mina. Here, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, no. ثُمَّ أَفِيضُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ أَفَاضَ النَّاسُ. You have also to return from the same place, from where the other people return. وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهُ. And ask for the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For your mistake, for your misdeed, that you had concocted yourself some ideas. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving and merciful. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمْ مَنَاسِكَكُمْ. And when you have completed all your rituals, فَاسْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ عَبَاكُمْ. Now 2 or 3 days stay at Mina. That is for zikr of Allah. And here now, فَاسْكُرُوا اللَّهَ. Now remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَذِكْرِكُمْ عَبَاكُمْ وَأَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. As you used to remember your forefathers. Rather more strongly, you should make the zikr of Allah, not of forefathers. They have gone back. They have passed. تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ لَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. It was the practice of the Quraysh that they used, you know, to praise their forefathers. But here the praise is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now you don't praise your forefathers, you praise Allah. You make zikr of Allah. فَاسْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاكُمْ وَأَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا. فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. Very important. There are among the people who say, even in Hajj, they pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا. Oh Allah, give us everything in this world. All their prayers are concerning this world. Give us wealth, give us money, give us sons, give us this thing, give us that thing, all of this world. Even at Hajj, they are praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only regarding this life and this world. فَمَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. For such a person, there will be no share in the hereafter. Because all his intentions, they are concerned with this world, and he is praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the goods of this life and this world also. So in Akhirah, in the hereafter, there will be no reward, no share. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ اللَّهِ. And from among there are those people also who say, Oh Lord, oh our Lord, give us the goods of this world also and the good of the Akhirah, of the hereafter also. وَقِنَا عَذَابَ اللَّهِ. And save us from the punishment of fire. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا. They are the people for whom there will be share from which they have earned. They will be able to partake from their earnings. Why part? Why not the whole? Because it will depend upon the sincerity, the amount of sincerity. If a person is 100% sincere in his good deeds, then he will get the 100% reward. But if his sincerity is somewhat polluted, then you know the reward also will be diminished. But anyhow, of the good deeds, a person would have, if he is really praying for it, and he has the intention of having goods of Akhirah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them some share of their earnings. وَاللَّهُ سَرِيُّ الْحِسَابِ. And Allah is very swift in reckoning. وَاسْكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامِ مَعْدُودَاتِ. Now note the same word, أَيَّامِ مَعْدُودَاتِ, which appeared concerning the psalm. Ayyam Ma'dudat. Here Ayyam Ma'dudat again appears, and it is for 2 days or 3 days. وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامِ مَعْدُودَاتِ. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during those numbered days, that is the stay at Mina. فَمَنْ تَعَجَّلَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ. Whosoever returns early after only 2 days, فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ. There is no sin on him. He is not to blame. وَمَنْ تَأَخَّرَ. Who delayed for 1 day, فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ. There is no sin on him also. لِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Provided they have taqwa. Otherwise you might be staying for a month over there. But if there is no taqwa, To what avail? To what use? Nothing. So if you have taqwa, if you have stayed for 2 days, it's okay. If you have stayed for 3 days, okay. But if you don't have taqwa, you might have stayed there for a month of no avail. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. And have regard for Allah. Fear Him. Fear that you will have to explain everything to Him on the Day of Judgment. وَعَلَمُوا. And keep it in mind. أَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. That you will be gathered before Him. You will be gathered before Him. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُعْجِبُكَ قَوْلُهُ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. And there are from among the people such persons whose talks, whose speech pleases you very much, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this life of this world. Some people are very worldly wise, very talkative. They can, you know, they can assure you of their sincerity. But actually they have a different character. Within them there is something else. This character is now being discussed, and this is actually the character of the munafiqeen. And the person here actually, that is in the background, is Abdullah ibn Ubay, the chief of the munafiqeen. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُعْجِبُكَ قَوْلُهُ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ مَا فِي قَلْبِهِ. And he repeatedly calls on Allah to witness on whatever is in his heart. By God, I am sincere. By God, I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever I am saying is, I am saying out of sincerity, utmost sincerity. وَهُوَ عَلَدُّ الْخِسَامِ. While in reality, he is the most stubborn, quarreling person. And he is most quarreling of the opponents, of the enemies. عَلَدُّ الْخِسَامِ. وَإِذَا تَوَلَّى. It can be translated in 2 ways. When he turns his back, he goes away from you after talking. Or it can be mean also tawalla, walaya. If he gets power, then what he does? Safi fil ardi yufsida fiha. Now he goes and struggles to have mischief in the world, on this earth. Wa yuhlik al harsa wal nasl. And he wants to destroy the tillage, the crops, and the cattle. And Allah loves not, وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَسَادِ. Allah doesn't like corruption and mischief. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهِ. And when it is said to him, have fear of Allah, mend your ways, what are you doing? You shouldn't do it like that. When you go to the Prophet, you are so sweet, you are talking, you know, so sweetly, you are time and again calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to witness, and now what are you doing? When you are not in His presence, your attitude is absolutely opposite. How come? But you must have some fear of Allah. You must bend your ways. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهِ أَقَذَتْهُ الْعِزَّةُ بِالْإِسْمِ. His false sense of respect and honor, it makes him stick to his sin. How can he admit that I did something wrong? I can't admit. My honor, my self-respect doesn't allow me. I cannot go and accept the guilt that I have done this. فَحَسْبُهُ جَهَنَّمُ. So, for him, Jahannam is sufficient. وَلَبِئْسَ الْمِهَادُ. And that is a very bad place, resting place. On the contrary, I told you in the Quran, it's a general practice, simultaneous contrast. When we have discussed one character of munafiqeen, now the character of the mu'mineen, as-saliheen, as-sadiqeen, the true mu'min. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْرِي نَفْسَهُ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ. And from the same people, there are those also who sell themselves, sell their lives, sell their money. What does it mean? They give their life, they give their money. ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ. What for? To get the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are ready to sacrifice everything. وَاللَّهُ رَوْفٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. And surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very gracious with His bondmen, with His servants. يا أيها الذين آمنوا ادخلوا في السلم كافة. O you who profess to believe, enter Islam. And what is Islam? Submission to Allah. But enter in this totally, not partially. Kaffatan. As a whole, your whole personality, your whole life should be in the form of submission before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only a part of it. Praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bowing before Him in ruku and sujood. But when you go out from the mosque, you are contravening the laws of Sharia. Now you just forget that riba is haram, interest is haram. Get anything at mortgage, just sign a pact, sign a form, and that is, you get the best car, you get a very good bungalow. And there you just forget that what is halal and what is haram. So this is not entering Islam totally. It's only partial. And yesterday we read that ayah. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. Do you accept a part of our scripture and law and sharia and reject the other part? فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. There can be no punishment for those who take to this attitude, except that they should be put to extreme humiliation in this world, in this life. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةَ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. And on the day of judgment, they should be thrown in the worst of punishments. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ادْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ كَافَّةً. Enter Islam, but totally. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطَوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. And don't follow the footsteps of Shaitan. إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ. Verily, he is a clear enemy to you. فَإِنْ زَلَلْتُمْ. And if you slip, مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاتْكُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. After all these clear teachings having come to you, فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Now keep in mind, Allah has all the authority, almighty, and He is the wise. If before coming of this Quran, you were doing something wrong, there could be some excuse. After all these things have been revealed to you, after this Mu'izzah has come to you, after this guidance has been revealed to you, now if you slip from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the path of the Sharia, then you will be brought to the book that Allah is Almighty. هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا يَأْتِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظُلَلٍ مِّنَ الْغَبَابِ. What are they waiting for? You know, there is a weakness with many of the human beings. They go on postponing. I shall become good after some days. Let me do this and let me do this, then I will adopt the full Sharia. Before that, I have these things to perform and these duties to perform. So he goes on postponing his Islam, his actual practice of Islam, he goes on postponing. And maybe the death takes him, overtakes him. What will happen? هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ. What for they are waiting? إِلَّا أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظُلَلٍ مِّنَ الْغَمَامِ. Are they waiting for that day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come in the shadows of the clouds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will descend on earth. We don't know how, but He will. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. There will be a descent. حَتَّى إِلَّا أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظُلَلٍ مِّنَ الْغَمَامِ. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ. And the angels will also come. وَقُضِيَ الْأَمْرِ. And all the matters will be decided and settled forever. What does it mean? Then it will be the decision, final judgment. There will be no possibility of any apologies. There will be no possibility of going back, returning to the world, of repenting, of mending the ways. Then actually everything will be decided for good. وَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُرْجَعُ الْأُمُورِ. And towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be returned all the matters. سَلْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ كَمْ آتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ آيَةٍ بَيِّنَةٍ. Ask the children of Israel, how many clear signs we gave to them. They saw miracles after miracles, miracle after miracle. وَمَنْ يُبَدِّلْ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْهُ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. And whosoever changes the blessings of Allah after they have come to him, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very severe in punishment also. In one ayah actually is the reference to the first part of this surah. What had they been doing with the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? زُيِّنَ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. This life of this world has been made very attractive and beautiful for the kuffar. They love it. This life and its shine, its grandeur, it attracts them. زُيِّنَ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَيَسْخَرُونَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And they mock at the Muslims, at the Mu'mins. Look to these people. He thinks there'll be another world, and he will have all the bounty of Allah in that world. He is living in the hope of the other world. While we have all the amenities, all the luxuries, we are enjoying everything here in this world. So they mock at them. يَسْخَرُونَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And those who have taqwa, they will be over them, above them, on the day of judgment. وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. And Allah will give to whomsoever He will please, without reckoning, without any limits. كَانَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. Now it's a very important issue. Why there are different religions, different communities? What's the philosophy behind it? This ayah is also one of the most important ayat of this surah. And I have given it the name Ayatul Ikhtilaf. How ikhtilaf and differences in religion, they appeared. So it's the philosophy of history of Quran. كَانَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. All the people to begin with were one community. All progeny of Adam, they were all one community. They were on Tawheed, on Islam. They were not in darkness. They were in the light of Tawheed. Because the first man was also the first Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first prophet. فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ النَّبِيِّينَ. Now after that what happened? There were differences among the people. After Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, people divided. فَبَعَثَ اللَّهُ النَّبِيِّينَ مُبَشَّرِينَ وَمُنْزِرِينَ. So after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised and sent the prophets who were mubashirin and munzirin both. They were mubashirin, givers of the glad tidings, bringing the glad tidings to those who took to the right path. Were munzirin and warning those who took to the wrong path. وَأَنْزَلَ مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ. And He sent down with them the book with the truth. لَيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ فِي مَخْتَلَفُوا فِي. To judge between the people in all matters in which they had differed. وَمَخْتَلَفَ فِيهِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاتُوا الْبَيُّنَاتِ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ. And people who differed among themselves didn't differ except after the clear signs had come to them. They had the clear knowledge, they had the clear signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was not by mistake. The real cause was bagyam bainahum, seeking domination over each other. This domination, Adler's view of psychology, the urge to dominate, this is the real cause of differences which appear in religion. فَهَدَى اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِمَخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided to those who believed to the right path in all the matters in which there was differences. بِإِذْنِهِ, with His permission. وَاللَّهُ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. And it is for Allah that He guides to whomsoever He pleases towards the right path. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَنْ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ. Now again you'll find the description and the discussion about going to war for the cause of Allah. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَنْ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ. Did you think that you will enter Jannah, paradise? وَلَمَّا يَعْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Although to you those trials and tests and tribulations have not happened up till now, which came to those people who were before you, مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ Affliction and distress touched them. وَزُلْزَلُوا And they were shaken. حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ So that the prophet of the time and his companions who were with him, people who believed, they cried out, حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصُرُ اللَّهِ When the help of Allah will come. أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبٌ Then the glad tidings was given to them that the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not far away. It's nigh. It's very near. So don't shirk and don't avoid going to war for the cause of Allah. يَسَلُونَكَ مَعْذَا يُنْفِقُونَ Now that infaq. And they are asking you, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what should we spend? How much should we spend? And where should we spend? قُلْ مَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ Tell them, whatever you spend from your money, your wealth, فَلِلْوَالِدَيْنِ So first, you know, they should be spent on your parents. وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ Then your relatives. كِتْ أَنْ كِنْ وَالْيَتَامَى The orphans. وَالْمَسَاكِينَ And the poor and the needy. وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ And the travelers. وَمَا تَفْعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ Whatever good deed you will do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be knowing it. It will be in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالُ وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ Now going to war has been made mandatory and obligatory upon you. كُتِبَ Just as كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامُ Fasting has been made mandatory on you. Now it is that stage of the revolutionary struggle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When this war has been made mandatory, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْقِتَالِ It has been prescribed, it has been made imperative upon you to go to war. وَهُوَ كُرْهٌ لَكُمْ And it is abhorrent to you. وَعَسَانْ تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ That is just possible. That you are abhorring something, you don't like something. And it is really good for you. وَعَسَانْ تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا On the contrary, this is also possible. That you like something, you love something, وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ Although it is real, in reality, it's not good for you. It's injurious for you. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Allah knows and you don't know. يَسَلُونَكَ عَنِ الشَّهْرِ الْحَرَامِ قِتَالٍ فِيهِ They're asking you also about the sacred month, about going to war in it during that month. قُلْ قِتَالٌ فِيهِ كَبِيرٌ Tell them, Going to war in a sacred month is a grievous sin. But, وَصَدُّنَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ But preventing people from the cause of Allah, from the way of Allah, وَكُفْرٍ بِهِ And making kufr, and disbelieving him, وَالْمَسْجَدِ الْحَرَامِ And preventing people from going and visiting and pilgrimage to the Masjid al-Haram, وَإِخْرَاجُ أَهْلِهِ مِنْهُ And expelling the people of Makkah from it, أَكْبَرُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ That is a bigger sin in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْفِتْنَةُ أَكْبَرُ مِنَ الْقَتْلِ The same wordings, وَالْفِتْنَةُ أَشَدُّ مِنَ الْقَتْلِ We read before. وَالْفِتْنَةُ أَكْبَرُ مِنَ الْقَتْلِ Fitna, persecution, social order. If the social system is not under divine rule, that is much worse than killing. وَلَا يَذَالُونَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ فِيهِ And your enemies, these kuffar, will continue fighting against you during this sacred month. حَتَّى يَرُدُّوكُمْ Till they take you back from your deen, in istata'u, if they can. وَمَنْ يَرْتَدِدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينَهِ And listen, whosoever amongst you goes back from his deen, if under this pressure of the enemies of Islam, he gives up Islam and goes back to that deen of their forefathers, وَمَنْ يَرْتَدِدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينَهِ فَيَمُتْ And if he dies in that condition, وَهُوَ كَافِرٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ حَبِطَتْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ Such are the people who all deeds will go in vain, will be destroyed in this world as well as in the akhirah, in the hereafter. أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ And they are the people of fire and they will remain in that forever, forever. And now again the contrast. Some people only mentions, if there is a mention of such people, we don't have any example really that somebody went back from Islam to Kufr, to Irtidad. But you know, theoretically, because it could be possible for somebody, it was discussed here. And on the contrary, the simultaneous contrast, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. On the other hand, those people who believed, who had the real faith, and then they made the hijrah, they migrated at the orders of the Prophet ﷺ from Makkah to Medina. وَجَاهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Then they fought for the cause of Allah. They made jihad for the cause of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ. They are the people who are hoping, they are the candidates for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are hoping the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving and merciful. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسَرِ. They are asking you, O Prophet, now again social problems. They are asking you about wine and gambling. قُلْ فِيهِمَا إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ. Tell them, in both of them there is a grievous sin. وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ. But there are some benefits also for the people. وَإِسْمُهُمَا أَكْبَرُ مِنْ نَفْرِهِمَا. But the sin of the both of these is greater than the benefits in both of these. But that's all. Here, only this much. This was the first instruction about these two things. The final instructions, they will come in Surah Al-Ma'idah. وَيَسَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ. And they are asking you, what should they spend? قُلِ الْعَفْ. Tell them, whatever is surplus, whatever with you is more than your needs, give it away. Give it for the cause of Allah. كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَفَكَّرُونَ. In this way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes His signs, His teachings clear so that you ponder over them. فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. In this world also or in the hereafter also. وَيَسَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْيَتَامَى. And they are asking you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the orphans. قُلْ إِصْلَاحٌ لَهُمْ خَيْرٌ. Tell to work honestly in their property, to benefit them, is good. وَإِن تُخَالِطُوهُمْ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ. And if you intermix your properties and business with them, with theirs, they are your brothers. وَاللَّهُ وَإِن تُخَالِطُوهُمْ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ الْمُفْسِدَ مِنَ الْمُصْلِحِ. And Allah very well knows the person who is making mischief monger, from that person who actually wants to have good, to make a good deal about the orphans. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَعَنَتَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ رَحِيمٌ. He would have been hard upon you if Allah willed so. Surely Allah is mighty and wise. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات بذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about Iona, please visit us at www.tenzim.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.